short. Come on, somebody. If I, hey, look this way. If I am going to cook, help me, Jesus. If I'm going to cook, I'm going not just to get in a recipe book and try to read the recipe and do it myself. No, 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 no. I'm going to call Dr. Helen and say, Doc, have you ever fixed lasagna? And she's going to tell me, well, you put this amount in. I know the book says it, but you put this amount of salt in, you put this amount of flour, you put 3 eggs, and then let me see what it looks like on camera. Yeah, that looks right. Then you stir it up. Come on, somebody. And then you learn that way. Somebody teaching you. Are you with me? You can't get all your wisdom just by reading a book. You have to build a relationship with somebody that loves you enough to speak truth in your life. When they see error in your life, they can speak truth. But can I tell you, are you with me, yes or no?
Yes.
Wave your hand if you're with me. I want to tell you something. Most people already have their mind made up before they ever asked you for counsel. I don't know how many people have come to me and said, I'm going to do this, this, and this, and I've tried to talk them out of it, and they still went and did exactly what I told them not to do. And then they suffer the consequences. Are you listening to me? And then you want to go, I tried to tell you that this is the consequences. Look, everybody, look this way. Timothy says that you to obey those that have rule over you in the Lord. Why? Because I watch out for your soul. Good preacher, preacher. So mentorship, can I go a little bit deeper, yes or no? Mentorship guarantees your promotion. You want to be promoted? How many wants to be promoted? In spiritual things. Let me see your hand. Okay? So, esteem her and she will exalt you. She will bring you to honor when she embraces her. She will give to you a head of garland of grace. She will deliver a crown of splendor to you. Proverbs 4:8-9. Number four, mentors can be determined. Watch this. Mentors can determine. Ready? Your wealth. When I begin to change my finance, everybody look this way. My financial structure, I was working three jobs. Three. Everybody say three.
Three
jobs. The last job, they let me sleep. Thank God. They let me sleep beside a board. And the only thing it would do is it'd wake me up if something went wrong. So they let me sleep. I had three jobs because I believe in supplying and taking care of your family.
Amen.
Are you with me? Yes or no?
Yeah.
But I said, I got to break this. I can't work three jobs. Plus, I was evangelizing and traveling. That's hard on me. So I said, I got to break this cycle. So I looked around, and I had people around me thinking the same way. The same people that I had around me, the people that I grew up with, and they were in my same financial structure. So I said, I've got to change this. So a doctor invited me over to his house one day for a special meeting, and it was a multi-level meeting, and there's nothing wrong with that, and I teamed up with it for a little while. But one of the reasons I teamed up for it wasn't that I thought I was going to get rich overnight, but I wanted to hang around the rich people to see how they live. See, how did you get to where you are? And I begin, y'all not with me today. I begin to see that they think different. They work different. Come on, somebody. They let their money work for them. They don't work for money. One doctor told me, while I'm asleep, my money's working for me in China right now. I don't know about you, but while I'm asleep, I want my money to be working for me somewhere, making me some interest, somebody. Give God a shout of praise if you believe that. Some of you can't hang with this because you're 40 and 50 years old and this is all you know. But let me help you with something. Colonel Harlan Sanders was 68 years old. 68 years old, he received his first pension check and he said, I failed at everything in life. I'm going to try fried chicken. And you know the rest of the story. In every city, there's a Kentucky Fried Chicken at the age of 68 years old. Are you listening to me today? It's never too late to change your financial structure. Give God a shout of praise. You know what I love about Chick-fil-A? You know what I love about told me, how much do they lose every Sunday? You told us. Here, how much? They, Chick-fil-A loses $18 million every Sunday by not being open. $18 million every Sunday because they are not open. They're not open like Burger King. They're not open like McDonald's. They're not open like all the other restaurants. They are closed on Sunday because they honor the Lord's Day. And guess what? That $18 million has been up, made up many, 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 many times because they honored the Lord. In fact, I believe he's gone now. What's his name? Truett?
Yeah.
Truett Cathy. He was a Sunday school teacher at Liberty University, son, where you graduated from. He was a Sunday school teacher. He believed in the principle of mentorship, and he'd take people under his arms. Are you listening to me? And he would teach them. When everybody look this way. When the worst crisis came his way, he had lost his shop. One of his family members had died, and he's lying in bed. He's broke. He's about to go bankrupt. And he thought to himself, what do I like? What do I like? Are you listening to me? He said, I like chicken. He's in his hospital bed. And he said, I like chicken. I like chicken patties. He said, and I like dinner rolls. I wonder if I can put a chicken patty on a dinner roll. It's never been done. And from that little idea, come on somebody. From that little idea, he's now known as one of the wealthiest entrepreneurs because he honored God and he had a mentor in his life to lead him and guide him. Look, you don't go under a bridge today and ask somebody that's broke, help me with my finances. They don't know how to manage finances. That's why they're there. Get somebody, come on somebody, that puts God first and honors. I'm going to hit it hard to make sure there's nobody left but me in this church. Hallelujah. At least I can count on me. I had come into a lot of money. This has been a while back when the heart doctor threw me the Omega XL, and I told that story.
Yeah.
When he threw the Omega XL to me, and we put it on an infomercial, and from that infomercial, it made millions and millions and millions of dollars just by a heart doctor throwing me a bottle of pills for a routine heart checkup. And he said, try this. And I liked it so much, my triglycerides started going down. Are you hearing me?
Yeah.
I started feeling better. I was losing weight, and I need to do it again. Hallelujah. And I said, we need to put this on TV. So we just did a little infomercial, didn't write a script, didn't do anything, had live testimonials. It went across the nation, and it was for every $1 we were spending, we were making $8. That's unheard of in infomercials. Unheard of. Usually 2 to 1 or something like that. $8 per $1. And then a wealthy man, or you want to hear this, yes or no?
Yes.
A wealthy man came and said, we want to buy this. I said, well, it's not for sale. He said, well, I give you, and it was really, 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 really high. And I said, it's sold. And the first and 15th, I get a check and never lifted a finger. And that guy became a financial mentor to me. Yo, are you getting this message? You need to get around someone that thinks differently. But I said all that for this reason. This money started coming in that I wasn't used to. It was money I didn't work for. I didn't lift my finger. It was just coming in. Every first and 15th, this big, fat, juicy check was coming. Hallelujah. And I tithed on it. You're going to hear it all day long. And I tithed on it. Turn to your neighbor and say, he's a tither. I think we got that point across. So, I said, I need a financial mentor. And they recommended to me a Christian mentor. A Christian mentor, financial. And I won't mention his name because some of you may be using it. And he said this to me. I said, well, I want to tithe. He said, well, you know, the way I teach my people is this. You don't need to give God 10% right away. He said, first of all, start off with 2%. And then he said, you gravitate to 4%. And then you go 6%. And then finally, a couple years down the road, you're going 8% and 10%. I shook his hand. And I said, I can't use you. I'm sorry. Y'all didn't get that. I said, I've been taught different. My dad taught me from the age of 13 that when I was working, that every penny that came in, I tithe. I didn't see where it's, I'm preaching. No, I'm not responding. But I don't see where it says, and give God 2% and work your way up to 10%. It said, prove me, Peter will say to the Lord, that I will not open the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing. If you believe that, give God a shout of praise. So my question to you is, Marcus Wayne softly, is this. And I've got much more to talk, but listen to me, look this way. Let me ask you this. Who is the mentor in your life? Who is the person that is speaking into your life? Look this way. Do they have an exemplary life as a spiritual leader?
Come on, Bishop.
Here's what you have to ask. Because there's a lot of people that talk Christian.
Right.
And it's nothing more than religion.
That's right.
And religious devils are the most difficult devils to deal with. Because they know it all. And that you can't teach them anything. And it was religion that hung Jesus on the cross. I hope you're getting something out of this today. Are you hearing me? So my first question is, who is your mentor? You need someone to speak into your life. And I'm going to say this, and this is, I think, healthy in a spiritual sense. Every female needs a female mentor. And every male needs a male mentor. Because when you become a mentor to someone, you get very familiar with them. And the last thing you want to do is have a female mentor and you get too familiar. Oh, Lord Jesus, help me in this church. So everyone say this. Mentorship can determine my wealth. Proverbs 8:18. Write this down. With me are riches and honor, enduring wealth and prosperity. Mentorship, number 5, can paralyze, I want to stop on this one, can paralyze your enemies against you. Look, if you have a real mentor, they will fight in the trenches with you.
Amen.
You didn't.
Yes.
Let me give it to you. Luke 21:15. For I will give you a mouth and wisdom which all your adversaries will not be able to withstand or contradict. That means this. Terry, come up here quick. If I am mentoring Terry, look this way, everyone, and we have this bond, because with mentorship there has to be a bond.
That's right.
And there has to be a trust.
That's right.
And there has to be loyalty.
That's right.
Yes.
That's right. Integrity.
Yes.
If I can't trust Terry, then I cannot mentor him.
That's right.
If I can't speak into his life, and he might get mad, but then he goes around and tells everybody, then it's defeated the whole purpose.
Right.
Come on now. Amen.
Amen.
Just recently, I had to sit someone down from our security. And it's not who or what or what happened. I just had to do it. It was difficult to do. I don't like to sit people down. But they had messed up royal in front of the church. And as a leader, it is my responsibility that if they mess up like that, I can't have that nonsense going on at my church. So I said, it's time for you to sit down. And you got to learn.
Right.
Controlled strength.
That's good.
Wisdom. Say amen.
Great tension.
But here it is. Here it is. Are you getting anything out of it?
Great tension.
So, if I'm mentoring, first thing that happens is there's a loyalty and a trust and a bond. I can tell him anything, and he can share with me. And I've often said this, I will take things to my grave. Things that would shock most people, I would take it to my grave. And I won't treat people differently. This is great teaching.
That's great teaching.
It's not preaching, but it's teaching.
Listen.
But then, like Ruth, according to these scriptures right here, his friends become my friends.
That's right. That's good.
And his enemies become my enemies.
That's right.
And I will fight for somebody that I'm mentoring.
That's right.
And I will always give this person, whoever it is, the benefit of the doubt.
That's right.
They may say, I call him doing so and so, la la, and I got pictures and all that. And I say, okay, let me see the pictures. Okay, he did all that. All right, I'll deal with it. You've done your part. And then I deal with it. Are you with me? But I don't expose him. Are you listening to me? I don't expose him. And I don't tell him the congregation how bad he is. I just tell him that I love him. I've got your back. And you're part of me, and I'm a part of you. Everyone shout mentorship. Get anything out of this today, everybody. That's what we pray.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Everyone standing, my next question is this. As you stand, my next question is this. Who is your protege? In other words, listen to me. Who are you mentoring? Are you listening?
Yes.
Who are you mentoring? Who are you speaking into their life? Who is it? I got these young preachers. I guess they think I'm old now. I had one preacher recently said, I just want to speak in that historical pulpit of Without Walls. Sound like I'm ancient, historical pulpit with that wall. Like I was with Amy Semple McPherson or something. I just want to speak in that historical pulpit. And he said, I can just speak once. He put that on my resume that I spoke in that historical church with that wall. Man, I'm getting old. But I have these young guys coming up 20, 30 years old, and they're always like this. Will you mentor me? Will you educate me? Will you school me? And then I put some of the requirements down. And suddenly, the text stops. And I don't hear from them for months. And then I look on my Instagram, and I see, they've done decided to go to somebody else.
Break it down.
Because if they're going to sit under me, are you all with me?
Yeah.
Then I'm going to make it to the standard that I believe God wants us to have in this church. Yeah. Give God the biggest shout out.
Hallelujah!
Thank you, God.